So hello everyone, once again this is MC Nandini Aravindan. Sorry for the internet issue. Okay, so I'm just waiting for people to join. Let me just take a breath. Yes. Okay. That's really nice. I would like to see some people, then I'll get started. Okay, so I have got a message, I suppose. Okay. Well, I think you know people have joined. Okay, hi Lavanya, hi Sumana, how are you? Thanks for joining. And I think yes, now it's going on. So good. Okay. Good. Okay, hi everyone. Hari Haran. Okay, everyone. Good. So I just wanted to start off. Okay, what is this about? Sankirti. Fine. Hi Anna. How are you? So this is going to be a very casual live. As you all know, every day I'm doing it. And this is part of 21-day FB live challenge. So I'm taking the day 10th challenge. And yes, Paneer Selvam has joined. Raymond, Derek, Amma, Pandi. Okay, everyone. Hi. And here, hi. Hi Anna, hi. So I'm just talking to two cameras, that is here one and here one. That is one in my laptop and one in my mobile. Okay, hi Tamir, fine, everyone has joined, good. Well, this is about, as I already said, 21-day FB live challenge. And so today I'm going to discuss a topic, two topics. That is, one is to choose your words carefully. So how to choose your words carefully, how to talk carefully. And second topic is about three A's of life, which is leading to the fourth A. Okay, so I just want for the second one, if someone has predicted what are those A's, okay, the three A's, can just type the messages, can just drop in your comments, because the A's are going to be like really, really very, very positive, and that's going to be really common where people don't appreciate a lot of things, but the three A's are going to be like a very, very, you know, life changing thing if you are practicing on an everyday basis, or if you're practicing in your life on a daily basis. That's going to change a lot of things in your life, because I have personally experienced it, and this has been completely formulated by me. So there's no way that, you know, you can find anywhere in the Google. So Anbanavan. okay. So he's giving that topic. That's nice. Okay, interesting. But maybe you can just try for some other topic, some other A's as well. All right. Very curious about the topic from Tamil. Good. Fine. I'm super excited. From your first day video, I guess the first A is affirmation. All right. That's a good guess. Well. Okay, let's see. Fine. Let's get into the first topic. So meanwhile, you can just drop in your comments. So I'll be really very happy to get more comments. Only then that can be a very healthy discussion. It's good, like, you know, even I can get to know more about A's, right? About A's. A's. Okay? Fine. So let me just get into the first topic that I have it for today. That is nothing but choose your words carefully. Okay? So this is also, I just want to start off with a very small illustration, and maybe a very small narration. It's a small story. Once there was a farmer, okay. Actually, that farmer has realized he has done some mistakes, okay. So, hi Koteshwari, hi Kuti Gopi, hi Prince Sabri, everyone. Hi. Thanks for joining. Well, so today I'm going to talk about two different topics that you can see about my live video. So, first topic is, you know, about to get started, I'm gonna give a very small narration. It's a story. Well, okay. So there's someone else. I'm seeing two cameras, because I'm doing a live in two cameras. Here one, that is you are seeing in the mobile, and you are seeing in the laptop. Okay, fine. Good. So the farmer has realized his mistake. Okay, there's a farmer out there somewhere in the country, in some other country. Okay, so he has realized his mistake. So he went to a preacher, okay, to a preacher, and he asked for forgiveness. Kindly forgive me for all the mistakes that I have done, okay? And the preacher said, yes, I will forgive you, but you have to do one thing for me, just to, you know, make sure that you have been forgiven. I'm going to give you a task, and that has to be done by you, okay? So the farmer said, yes, I can do it, my lord. So please tell me the task. That is what he said. And the preacher told him to take a bag full of feathers. So you just hear it very carefully. Bag full of feathers, okay? So the bag full of feathers was taken, and he asked the farmer to take the bag full of feathers and drop it on the center of the city, okay? He was living on a city, or maybe you can consider it as a town or whatever it is. Wherever he was living, he wanted to go and take and put that feathers on the center place, somewhere in the market or somewhere, okay? So he did the same, and he said, okay, my lord, I'm going to do the same thing, whatever you have instructed. Then the farmer went ahead with the bag full of feathers, and he dropped it on the center of the city, okay, the place, the market, and then he returned back. He came saying, like, you know, yes, my lord, I'm done with the work. So what next? What I have to do after this? He said, okay, just give me 1 hour. Just give me 1 hour. I'm going to do some meditation. If you can wait, please do wait here. I'll come back. Okay? So then he said, okay, after the 1 hour session, he said, okay, now you can go and collect back all the feathers in the on the same bag. So he has the bag, right? So on the same bag. Then he said, okay, my lord, I'm going to collect all the feathers back again. He went there. He saw none of the feathers, because each and every feather was dispersed, you know, in the air, and it was blown off completely, right? So it is natural that it has been blown off. Yes. And when he returned back, he said, I got only an empty bag, because I was not able to collect any of the feathers because everything was blown off. Okay. The preacher said, okay, I understand. So the same thing is true about your words. You drop the words rather easily, but you cannot retrieve them back. Am I right or wrong? So this was a thing which was told by the preacher. So he wanted to illustrate it through a very small task, and by which the farmer has understood his mistake. So the mistake was something he has told very, very, maybe a slang word or something, you know, while on a discussion with his business partner, and wherein they were not able to gel up again. So he said he was not able to understand, and the farmer said that he's not going to do business with that person anymore. So he came off and he walked away. So that's when he started grimacing, and then he came to a preacher saying, like, you know, this was my mistake, so kindly forgive me. And this preacher gave him a chance, and he gave him a task, and then he said this, that you drop the words rather easily, but you cannot retrieve them. You need to be very, very careful in choosing your words. So this is what he said. Yes. So everyone knows that it's very, very easy to drop the words, but it is very tough to take it back. In case, like, you know, we are speaking very, you know, we are speaking wrong, and we are doing some mistake in that sense, you know, probably if we are getting some agitation or something, you know, if we are losing our tranquility, obviously we lose our words, we drop more words, and that's when the problem starts, and you cannot collect it back, and that is what I'm going to discuss today. So you need to be very, very careful while choosing your words, right? Yes. So the next thing, while speaking over the mic, okay, for all the event MCs, this is very, very important. So while speaking over the mic, you need to be very careful, at the same time tactful. There is a word called tactful, T-A-C-T-F-U-L, okay? So what has been very tact? So tact consists of one word, so that is one's word that has to be carefully chosen, knowing how far to use it. So tact is nothing but, it is nothing but, you need to choose your words very carefully in order to use it, and you need to know how far you need to use it. That's called as tactfulness, okay? But when this is, you know, said, it may be really very vague. So let me just tell you in a very colloquial manner, tell it in a very colloquial manner, okay? It also means knowing what to say and what not to say. And that's called tactfulness, okay? So tactfulness is nothing but what to say and what to leave unsaid. So these two are the important points. There are many talented people, okay? There are many talented people who may feel like, you know, they are not able to achieve the success, or they cannot go to the pinnacle of success. It's because they lack tactfulness. They may be talented, but they are not tactful. So tactful is like, it will reflect your attitude, and also talent without tact always is undesirable. So talent without tact is always undesirable. So try to acquire some tactfulness while speaking. So you may not be like a very good speaker, you may not be a very good speaker, but at least you can learn how to speak tactfully. So that's more important, okay? Words actually reflect your attitude. And there are people who have, maybe I should say this way, I should put it in this way. Words can hurt the feelings, okay? And it can destroy relationships, as everyone knows. It can even bond two people together, and it can even break the bond easily just by speaking out some words, right? But more people have been hurt by an improper choice of words, okay? More people have been hurt by improper choice of words than even by a natural disaster. So natural disasters, like, you know, people will be dying in the natural disasters. That's true, and that's the universal fact. But getting hurt by words, the wrong words, is like even more than the natural disasters, it seems. So this was like taken over a survey, and people have told a lot more, you know, expressed a lot more emotion, saying like, you know, I've been hurt by words than by physical illness or some ailments. So this is what the survey says. So this one line I would like to quote, that is, choose what you say rather than say what you choose. Choose what you say rather than say what you choose. You might be, you know, wondering what is the difference, but there's going to be a lot of difference. One is more of wisdom, the other is more of foolishness. So this is more of wisdom and this is more of foolishness, okay? That is, first one is choose what you say. Choose what you say. The second is say what you choose. So when you choose what you say, that's going to be the wisdom. When you say what you choose, that's going to be foolishness. So you need to act upon it. This is called as tactfulness. Acting upon your words is called as tactfulness, okay? So yes, and the last thing that I would say about this is, excessive talking does not mean a communication, or a communication is not about too much of talking, okay? You need to talk less and say more. Talk less and say more. They say like talk less and work more. But even before that, you need to just ensure you talk less and say more. When you say something, that's going to be like more productive. When you talk something, there is a probability that it can be a loose talk also, you know. So that's the reason why they say excessive talking does not mean a communication, okay? So today's topic, the first topic, is almost done. I hope, you know, people who are watching was a little bit enlightened with this, because choosing your words carefully is the most important thing for all the speakers, for all the ones who entertain others, for all the performers, because once you take the stage, you need to know what you have to speak. If you're not sure of what you are going to speak, then that's going to be like a real blunder on the stage. So let's be really tactful while speaking, and also careful while choosing, before choosing the words. So that's what I said, that one line was very, very important. So I'm going to repeat that one line here. Choose what you say, rather say what you choose. So choose what you say is wisdom, and say what you choose is foolishness. Okay? So keep this in mind, and we are going to move on to the next topic. So I already got some comments. I'm just looking for the comments. Okay, and that's Anbanavan, Asaradavan, or Adangadavan. Okay, that's going to be the full name. Okay, I was asking for three A's, and can each one can give their views. What will be the three A's? Okay, from your first day video, I guess first A is affirmation. Okay, Tamil has said, okay, a good try. And Lavanya Mohan has said attitude. That's also a good try. Well, Adaitan. Okay, I don't understand what he said. Vida Anavatila. Okay, Ranavatila Arinjavana Vida Anavatila Arinjava Adigamna Sulvanga. Okay. Fine, this was for my first one, right? Okay, attitude. Kadambari. That's nice. Hi, Kadambari. How are you? Hi, Lakshmi Priya. Hi. So, hi to everyone. So, I'm going to continue one more. I'm going to continue with my second topic. That's three A's of life leading to the fourth A. Hello Suresh sir, hello Aisha, hello Prabhas, everyone. Okay, fine, I'm going to continue the second topic. Three A's. Thank you for all the suggestions that you have given. It's really very nice to read that, and some were really close to my A's. But okay, let me just disclose it. I don't want to hold more than this because it's already 17 minutes. And I'm going to release the first A. That's acknowledgement. Okay? Assertiveness. Lokesh Ram. That's good. So this is, like I said, even in the beginning, this is a very, very simple thing that is going to make that fourth A. So you don't have to go to, too many technical terms like assertiveness. Assertiveness comes after this. So this is just the basic thing that I'm going to discuss today. The three A's are going to be very simple: acknowledging, appreciation, and applause. Okay, I'm going to type this also, don't worry. So acknowledgement, appreciation, and applause. Why? Because these three things are to be considered for a speaker, an MC, an anchor. So that is why I chose these three things. Okay. So why these three things are very important? Acknowledgement. When someone speaks from the crowd, or when someone says something from the crowd, you need to acknowledge them. Okay, as a speaker, as an MC, as an anchor, you need to say at least you need to say an yes or no, or at least talk back, just answer them. Whatever they say, at least you have to acknowledge. So that is what is important first. Okay, so acknowledgement to all the speakers who are watching this. The first A is acknowledgement. Okay, as I'm watching two cameras, please pardon me, my views might go here and there. Hi Vijay, good, thank you for joining. So the first A is acknowledgement. The second A is appreciation. So appreciate people. When they say something good, when they do something good on the stage, or when they say something good from the crowd, do give them an appreciation. Well done, good job, something like that. You need to appreciate. And the third thing is applause. So when something is done really well, do ask the crowd or ask the audience to applaud and to give that recognition for that particular person who is performing there or who is speaking there, because that will build a very good image on the MC, on the anchor, over the anchor, just by doing these three things. If you do these three things, it's going to be like really, really an amazing stuff that is going to be created over you as an image. So if there's going to be a speaker or an anchor who is standing on stage, who is not acknowledging, who is not appreciating, or who is not applauding, making people applaud or herself applauding, then that's going to be a spoiled sport. Trust me, that's going to be a spoiled sport. But if she is, or he or she is, able to do all these three things, then they are going to be a very, very huge difference, and there's going to be a greater image building. Okay? And that anchor will be appreciated for all that he or she does. Yes? So these three things are very important. And what is that fourth A? That is going to be your attitude. So when acknowledgement, appreciation, and applause comes into picture, okay, all these three things comes into picture, the fourth A will be attitude. So these three things are there, then you are a very good attitude person, and that is what needed. That is what is needed for an anchor or maybe a speaker too. Yes. So this decides the attitude. I would say, like, in a very simple manner, these three things will decide the attitude of a person. Even if he or she is a speaker or an anchor, people will judge them. Oh, why is she not, you know, acknowledging people? Why is she not appreciating? Why is she not asking people to applaud? So they might have some, you know, sense of attitude, or they might form some image on you. So do not, you know, make them feel such kind. So please have a very good attitude. With attitude, all these three A's comes, you know, three A's come: acknowledgement, appreciation, and applause. Okay? So please remember this. And in Tamil, they say, "Parate enbadu vetriko tholviko alla, muyarchikaga mattume." So this has to be there in always in your mind. Okay? So yaradu orthanga muyarchi pandranga na, avangala vandu appreciate pannanum. Avangala vandu mathavangala vandu clap panna solli, applaud panna solli, avangala innum sandoshapaduthunga. Okay? So adhudha neenga vandu oru MCA ku irundinga na, oru anchor a irundinga, oru speaker a irundinga, avangalukku kudukkakoodiya oru mariyada. Okay? So andha maari irukkumbodhu andha moonu vishayatha neenga marakkama endha oru stage a irundhalum neenga indha moonu vishayatha seiyalam. Just yosichu paarenga. இந்த மூணு விஷயம் செய்கிறதுனால உங்களுக்கு ஏதாவது வந்து லாஸ் இருக்குதா? கண்டிப்பாக இல்லை, கண்டிப்பாக இல்லை. நீங்கள் இந்த மூணு விஷயம் செய்யாமல் போனீங்கன்னா மட்டும்தான் உங்களுக்கு லாஸ் இருக்குது. அதுவும் உங்களோட இமேஜில், உங்களோட ஆட்டிடியூடில் பெரிய ஒரு லாஸ் இருக்குது. பீப்புள் பார்க்குறவங்க பார்த்தீங்கன்னா, ராமசுப்ரமணியம் சார், ஹலோ சார், அண்ட் குமரன் சந்தோஷ், வர்தி டைம் ஃபார் மீ, தேங்க்ஸ் ஃபார் ரிமெம்பரிங், டாக்ஃபுல், வெல்கம். ஜெயந்தி, ஹாய். ஸோ விஜய் ராதாகிருஷ்ணன், டூயிங் கிரேட், தேங்க்யூ, தேங்க்யூ. So yes, so in the moon A's one is very very important: acknowledgement, appreciation, applause, and these three things will lead to a good attitude. So ninga speaker a irundinga, ninga anchor a irundinga, idu moonu vishayatha kandipa makkalukku marakkama kondu serunga. Ena idu moonu vishayamum ungalaoda life ku seri, ninga stage yerathukku munnadiyum seri appuramum seri, it will be really really very useful. So stage yerathukku munnadi nam idu moonu vishayathai niyabam vechukonga. Okay, namba vandu kandipa yaar enna sonnalo avangalukku nalla acknowledgement kudukonum. அண்ட் அவங்கள வந்து ஏதாவது ஒரு விஷயம் நல்ல விஷயம் பண்ணாங்கன்னா அவங்களை அப்ரிஷியேட் பண்ணணும். அண்ட் அவங்க நல்ல விஷயம் பண்ணி அது எல்லாருக்கும் பிடிச்சிருந்துச்சுன்னா அவங்கள அப்லோட் பண்ண சொல்லணும். அப்படிங்கிற ஒரு மூணு விஷயத்தை வந்து நீங்கள் ஒரு அஃபர்மேஷன் மாதிரி கூட எடுத்துக்கலாம். நான் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் டே உங்களுக்கு அஃபர்மேஷன் பற்றி சொல்லியிருந்தேன், பாசிட்டிவ் அஃபர்மேஷன். இது எல்லாமே பாசிட்டிவ் அஃபர்மேஷன் தான். அண்ட் இன்ஃபேக்ட் இது வந்து வெறும் ஸ்பீக்கர்ஸ்க்கு மட்டும் இல்லை, ஒரு தனிப்பட்ட மனிதர்கள். ஓகே, தனிப்பட்ட மனிதனா, இப்போ நான் வந்து ஒரு ஸ்பீக்கர் இல்லை, ஆங்கர் இல்லை அப்படிங்கிற பட்சத்தில் நான் எங்கேயாவது போகிறேன், ஒரு வெளியில் எங்கேயாவது போகிறேன் அப்படின்னா, யாராவது ஒரு நல்ல விஷயம் பண்ணாங்கன்னா அவங்கள வந்து அதை அக்னாலேஜ் பண்ணலாம். ஹாய், நீங்கள் ரொம்ப நல்லா பண்ணியிருக்கீங்க அப்படின்னு சொல்கிறது அக்னாலஜ்மெண்ட். நீங்கள் ரொம்ப சூப்பராக பண்ணியிருக்கீங்க, இதை நீங்கள் கண்டினியூ பண்ணுங்கள் அப்படின்னு சொல்கிறது ஒரு அப்ரிசியேஷன். அதே வந்து ஒருத்தவங்க கிட்ட பக்கத்தில் இருந்தாங்கன்னா அவங்களே விட்டு அவங்களுக்கு வந்து ஒரு அவங்களுக்கு புரிதல் தன்மையை கொடுத்து அவங்கள வந்து இவங்க கிட்ட பேச வைக்கிறது, அதாவது இவங்களை அப்ரிஷியேட் பண்ண சொல்கிறதுங்கிறது இன்னும் ஒரு நல்ல விஷயம். அண்ட் இஃப் இட்ஸ் கோன் பி எ க்ரௌட், அது ஒரு பெரிய க்ரௌடாக இருந்துச்சுன்னா அவங்கள வந்து நம்ம பார்த்து சொல்கிறோம், ஓகே நீங்கள் ரொம்ப நல்லா பண்ணியிருக்கீங்க, நீங்கள் ரொம்ப சிறப்பாக பண்ணியிருக்கீங்க இந்த விஷயத்தை அப்படின்னு சொல்கிற பட்சத்தில் யூ கேன் மேக் அதர்ஸ் டு ஈவன் அப்லோட். ஸோ இது மூணு விஷயமும் நீங்கள் பண்ணுற தொட்டி நீங்கள் குறைஞ்சே போக மாட்டீங்க. ஸோ ப்ளீஸ் பேர் இன் மைண்ட். ஓகே, ஸோ இதோடு நான் இன்றைக்கி என்னுடைய உரையை முடிச்சுக்கிறேன். Okay, thank you so very much. And as I said, like in the first என்னுடைய ஃபர்ஸ்ட் லைவ்ல இருந்து உங்களுக்கு ஜஸ்ட் ஒரு ரீகேப் பண்ணுறேன். ஃபர்ஸ்ட் லைவ் வந்து பாசிட்டிவ் அஃபர்மேஷன்ஸ் பற்றி பேசியிருந்தேன். ஸோ ப்ளீஸ் டூ கண்டினியூ டூயிங் தட். செகண்ட் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா, நான் இந்த 21 டே எஃபி சேலஞ்சில் செகண்ட் லைவ் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா, இட் வாஸ் அபவுட் 10 இம்ப்ரூவிங் டிப்ஸ் அபவுட் டு இம்ப்ரூவ் யூர் சாரி 10 டிப்ஸ் டு இம்ப்ரூவ் யூர் அப்பியரன்ஸ். ஸோ அதுதான் என்னுடைய செகண்ட் டே லைவாக இருந்துச்சு. தேர்டில் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா, எங்களுடைய வந்து சென்னை ஈவெண்ட் எம்சிஸ் பற்றி நாங்கள் ஒரு டிஸ்கஷன் வச்சுருந்தோம், நானும் தமிழும் சேர்ந்து ஒரு லைவ் பண்ணியிருந்தோம். அண்ட் ஃபோர்த் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா, நான் வந்து அக்யூப்ரெஷர் பாயிண்ட்ஸ் அண்ட் கிளாப்பிங் பற்றி அதுக்கான சிறப்பான விஷயங்கள் எல்லாமே நான் ஷேர் பண்ணியிருந்தேன். 7 குட் திங்ஸ் அபவுட் யூனோ கிளாப்பிங் அண்ட் ஆல்சோ அமேசிங் திங்ஸ் அபவுட் கிளாப்பிங், நாட் குட் ஜஸ்ட் குட் திங், அமேசிங் திங்ஸ் அபவுட் கிளாப்பிங் அண்ட் ஆல்சோ அபவுட் அக்யூப்ரெஷர் பாயிண்ட்ஸ். அந்த கிளாப் பண்ணுறதுனால என்னென்ன அக்யூப்ரெஷர் பாயிண்ட்ஸ் இங்கே வந்து உங்களோட கையில் ஆக்டிவேட் ஆக போகுது அப்படிங்கிறதையும் நான் வந்து சொல்லியிருந்தேன். அண்ட் நெக்ஸ்ட் வந்து பார்த்தீங்கன்னா, ஓகே நெக்ஸ்ட் வந்து ஒரு வீடியோ நேத்திக்கான வீடியோ என்னன்னு பார்த்தீங்கன்னா, உங்களுக்கு ஓகே அது நானே மறந்துட்டேன் ஆக்சுவலி. ஓகே, ஜஸ்ட் கிவ் மீ அ செகண்ட், ஐம் கோன் ரீவைண்ட் மை ப்ரெஷ் அப் மை மைண்ட். ஓகே, நேத்தி இதை பற்றி பேசியிருந்தோம், ஐ திங்க் சம்திங் ரிலேட்டட் டு எஸ் ஓகே ஸ்ட்ரெஸ் மேனேஜ்மெண்ட். ஸோ நேத்தி ஸ்ட்ரெஸ் மேனேஜ்மெண்ட் பற்றி பேசியிருந்தேன். ஸோ அதுக்கு முந்தின நாள் வந்து மைசெல்ஃப் அண்ட் தமிழ் ஹேட் எக்ஸ்பிளைன்ட் அபவுட் த டேபிள் கேம்ஸ். ஸோ நேத்தி வந்து பார்த்தீங்கன்னா ஸ்ட்ரெஸ் மேனேஜ்மெண்ட், ஹவு டு ஹேண்டில் ஸ்ட்ரெஸ். So, இன்னைக்கு பார்த்தீங்கன்னா உங்களுக்கு எல்லாருக்கும் தெரியும் ரெண்டு டாபிக் டிஸ்கஸ் பண்ணிருக்கோம் ஹவு டு சூஸ் யுவர் வேர்ட்ஸ் கேர்ஃபுல்லி அண்ட் த செகண்ட் திங் இஸ் 3 A's விச் லீட்ஸ் டு த 4th A. ஸோ இது ரெண்டுமே ரொம்ப ரொம்ப முக்கியமான ஒரு டாபிக் அண்ட் ஆஸ் அன் ஆங்கராக நீங்கள் எல்லாருமே வந்து கண்டிப்பாக இதை வந்து யூஸ் பண்ணிக்கலாம் அண்ட் ஆஸ் அ வெரி நார்மல் பர்சன் ஒரு காமன் பப்ளிக்காக கூட நீங்கள் இதை யூஸ் பண்ணிக்கலாம் ரொம்பவே ஒரு நல்ல விஷயமாக இருக்கும் தேங்க்யூ நான் நினைக்கிறேன் இன்னைக்கான டைம் வந்து ஓகே எவ்வளோ ஆச்சு 26 minutes ஐ திங்க் இதுதான் இருக்கிறதுலே சீக்கிரமான ஒரு லைவ் வீடியோ நான் முடிக்கிறதுன்னு நினைக்கிறேன் தேங்க் யூ ஈச் அண்ட் எவ்ரி ஒன் ஹூ ஆர் வாட்சிங் திஸ் அண்ட் இதனால் நீங்கள் பயன்பெறுவீங்கன்னு நினைக்கிறேன் பிகாஸ் இதோடைய ஓகே ஐ ஹவ் மென்ஷன் அனதர் டாபிக் ஓகே தமிழ் சேஸ் லைக் ஹி ஹஸ் மென்ஷன்ட் அனதர் டாபிக் ப்ளீஸ் சி யுவர் இன்பாக்ஸ் மென்ஷன் ஓகே ஓகே ஃபைன் 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 ஓகே எஸ் அண்ட் தேர்ஸ் ஆல்சோ ஒன் மோர் திங் லைக் யூ நோ ஐ வுட் லைக் டு எக்ஸ்பிரஸ் தட் இஸ் இந்த ப்ரீவியஸ் லைவ் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா தமிழரசன் மை குரு அண்ட் பிஸ்னஸ் பார்ட்னர் ஹி ஹஸ் டன் அ லைவ் சேயிங் அபவுட் தி ரெய்னி சீசன் த ப்ரிகாஷன் தட் யூ நீட் டு டேக் கேர் டியூரிங் தி ரெய்னி ரெய்னி சீசன் அண்ட் ஹவு யூ கேன் ஸ்டில் ஹாவ் ப்ரொடக்டிவ் ஒர்க் டியூரிங் தி ரெய்னி சீசன் தோஸ் டூ ஆர் த டாபிக்ஸ் விச் ஆர் டிஸ்கஸ்ட் ப்ரியர் டு திஸ் ஸோ இது வந்து நீங்கள் என்னுடைய ஆக்சுவலி டைம் லைனில் கூட பார்க்கலாம் இல்லை தமிழரசனுடைய டைம் லைனில் கூட பார்க்கலாம் பிகாஸ் தட் வீடியோ இஸ் ஆல்ரெடி தேர் அண்ட் தட்ஸ் அகெயின் அ லைவ் வீடியோ ஸோ ப்ளீஸ் டூ வாட்ச் தட் And I would also like to say you can also watch our all the lives in our YouTube channel which we have you know specially created for live and the YouTube channel oda link kuda I'll share it on the comments you can watch it and all our videos like live videos will be uploaded there so yes and today I'm going to wind up here so I'd like to thank my mentor Dr. Maharaja Sivasubramaniam to making me you know do this wonderful life and he was the initiative so he was our push behind this I should say and also my guru and my business partner MC Tamilarasan for making me you know do this life and one more person that is Mariza who initiated this live the FB 21 day FB live challenge so I'm really really grateful to all these three people thank you so much and I'm really thankful to all of you who are watching here watching me since the start of this video and porumiya neenga ungala patience oda you are watching me and I'm really really thankful for all your patience because it's already 12 AM so adutha naale vandiruchu thank you so much ivlo neram enkaga irundhu neenga paathadhu romba romba nandri and keep watching keep supporting so enudaiya youtube channel adukana link vandha tamil potutara engaloda youtube channel kana video link potutara adukana ella video um indha live videos ellame indha youtube channel la irukku so please do go watch that you know you can let us know your comments because that will help us you know to give more and more good topics to discuss more and more good topics because these are all not just you know discussing being discussed for namesake id namesake aga pannu naanga nenikala makkalukku edhaavadhu oru vishayam vandu daily oru vishayam solanum and in the fb challenge mooliyama nam edhaavadhu oru vishayam nam kondu seithona adu avangalukku edhaavadhu oru vegaila payan padradha irundhuchuna that will be like we'll be more happy on doing this because neenga pandra oru vishayam vandu ungalku nalla vishayama iruka illaya abingiradhu engalukku neenga sollana engalukku theriya varadhu but neenga adha engitta share panna mudinjuchuna we are like very very happy for that as well so kindly share your comments and neenga adha use pandreenga appadina indha topics ella naanga pesradhula you know at the end of every video I'm just wrapping up I'm winding up with all the you know suggestions that I'm giving throughout the video so adala eduthukitte neenga andha wrap up pandra session mattum kuda paatha neenga theriyum okay indha points nam pannala appadina neenga full video kuda paaka time illa appadina neenga wrap up pannum bodhu andha enna enna solreno andha points takeaway points neenga eduthukitta kuda neenga others practice panninga kuda you will get very good results so keep practicing and keep supporting us thank you so very much MC Nandini Aravindan signing off take care good night and stay blessed